When athletes feel rotten, this is what they do. Hey, I'm Uriel Kaim, and today I'm going to answer a very, I don't know if it's a question actually, it's just kind of something I've come across recently, I've been thinking about, is that athletes train quite a bit. And one of the biggest things, as a former pro soccer player, I can tell you about athletic training is that it's recovery that is the most important aspect of an athlete's training regime. Okay. If you think about, I'll just use the example of soccer because that's obviously where my background is. If you think about teams like Manchester United or Barcelona, they train, their training really is centered around their game. So they have a game on Saturdays or Sundays. They might have a Champions League game in midweek. They might have a cup game. So in any given week, they might have anywhere from 1 to 3 games. Then they're supposed to be training somewhere in there. And as you can tell, you start running out of time. So what do athletes do when they feel rotten? Because if you continue to train at that level in terms of volume and consistency and frequency, your body breaks down. So what should you do, even if you're not an athlete and you want to feel better, if you're just kind of worn down? Well, here's what you should do. You should actually train less and focus a little bit more on active recovery. Things like yoga, soft tissue management, so foam rolling, self-massage, even going to a massage therapist and getting some work done. But I think the big thing really here is, sorry, I've got an itchy nose, I got like some stuff floating around here, yoga is a huge thing that I think anybody, whether you're an athlete or not, should be doing on a regular basis. And the reason for that is because yoga is an active way of keeping yourself mobile. And let's say you work at a job, 9 to 5, you sit at a desk all day. Well, what happens there? Well, you're just hunched over at your desk, and unless you're taking frequent breaks and moving around, well, over time, that position will kind of mold itself into your body. And that's why we see so many people with postural problems nowadays, low back issues, because sitting is not a good thing for the human body. So yoga is such a great tool to use because it keeps you limber, it helps you kind of clear your mind and focus a little bit better. And I mean, I've used this with athletes for a number of years. I actually initiated this at the University of Toronto about 7 or 8 years ago. And we incorporated a 20-minute yoga routine that we did twice a week and sometimes 3 times a week. And within the space of 1 season, we reduced injury rates by 82%. 82%, guys. Initially, we had, obviously, most of the guys were like, well, yoga, I'm not going to do this, whatever. But they committed to it. We did it. And within the first session already, they were feeling unbelievable. So much more just kind of fluid, limber, less stiff, less heavy. So it's something I think that really everybody should do. Personally, I do yoga about 2 to 3 times a week in the mornings, just get my body started like that. And I'll usually use some form of flow yoga before my workouts as a way of dynamically warming up my body. So that is the number one thing I think anybody can do, including athletes, when you feel rotten. Okay. Now, if you want help with this kind of stuff, you can check out my Yoga for Athletes program, which is the routine I just told you about that we used at the University of Toronto. And the link for that is below this video. It's a tremendous routine. It's 20 minutes, so you don't have to go to a yoga studio and spend 3 hours in there besides sweaty people. This is something you can do at home, in your backyard, in the gym, wherever you like. It's an awesome routine. It's very simple to do, but very, very effective. All right, guys. So hopefully that this information has found you well, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video.